It was a very spontaneous celebration of victory. The people crowded as far as I could see. I very vividly remember the Union Jack coming down and the Lion flag being hoisted.
I think my earliest recollections were these planes flying over, and I remember parades, no television, so we may have seen pictures in the newspapers the next day.
I remember my mother bought me a national flag and said it's Independence Day, so you had to put it up. And then later on the same day, I watched the Independence the parade on TV.
We would be given this plain black and white picture of a Sri Lankan flag, which we would color this in, and then attach it to the little stick from a nickel broom. And we would clutch this flag all day long.
We had only one particular thing in mind. We are taking it over from the British, that we are repossessing our heritage. We are getting back our kingdom to ourselves. Other details did not quite matter at that point. Achievement was sufficient or not, had to come later.
Independence for what? Because we just passed on the rule from British capitalist interest to Sri Lankan capitalist interest. If you look at the British, what they left behind, we follow their parliamentary system. Hundreds of years old, and just failed us. So people realize that these institutions are not the best forms of governance for us. Take the British education system. What have we done? We have taken it and made it even worse. We have taken it, put our children through scholarship, standardized testing, shove so-called knowledge down their throat. And what do? Take away their independence.
Today, we are highly reliant on Chinese. Some time back, we were reliant mainly on the West. So we've been, even though we have gained the independence to govern, but we are still have to be ruled by the conditions that come from other nations.
Independence is not this abstract concept. But it's something that sort of thrusts upon us a certain obligation and an accountability to make something of what we have gotten.
So therefore, we must allow the children to rethink the history of independence. And guidance should be provided by leaders, by teachers, and even with the religious leadership, that responsibility rests to make the people aware of what we achieve. That's an imperative at this moment.
70 years later, even technologically, we are completely dependent on foreign nations because of all kinds of corruption. Shouldn't we be building a just and sustainable society? I mean, our goal should be to bring people together.